Today we are going to design an Excenter lever with free software. Excenters have many uses in a shop, such as holding a workpiece in place or gluing up panels. In my last video, I created these adjustable floating shelves. As I don't have an engineering background, it took me quite some time to understand how to best design an Excenter lever. In this video, I want to share these learnings with you. Let's first have a look at the basics, how an excenter works. If we have a circle and just punch a hole in it, the distance between the hole and the border of the disc will stay constant as the disc turns. We can move the hole out of the center, which creates a basic excenter. If we roll this one, the distance to the border is increasing till the midpoint and is decreasing afterwards. We use only half of the contour this way to increase the pressure. To improve the usage and effectiveness, we would have to add more material to the second half of the circle. This is what's called a spiral excenter. I tried to design it in CAD but actually didn't succeed. The solution I ended up with was to use the free software Inkscape. If you want to follow along and don't have it already installed on your computer, go to www.inkscape.org and download the latest version of the software. Follow the instructions to install it on your computer. In the software, we click on the spiral tool and draw a spiral. In the upper part of the window, you can change the size of the spiral. For me, that's 100 times 100 millimeters. We then change the turns to 1.8 so that the spiral covers a little more than 1.5 turns. This tool here is a measurement tool. We first click on the center of the spiral and then drag the mouse to the outside at the narrowest and then at the widest point of the spiral. The difference between these two values equals the amount of pressure that we can create with the excenter. In my case, the width of the spiral ranges from 28 mm at the narrowest to 75 mm at the widest point. The difference between these two values is 29. If we want to reduce the travel down to 8 mm, we divide 8 by 29 and put the resulting 0.28 in the divergence field of the spiral tool. We can use the measurement tool to control the two distances. In this case, that's good enough for me. As soon as we're done with the spiral, we click on this icon in order to snap to the center of objects. We then create a circle. This will be the center hole, so we change its size to fit our axle and move the center of the circle to the center of the spiral. Next, we draw a rectangle and use the circle icon to give it round corners. This rectangle is so that we can turn the excenter easier and we position it at the opening of the spiral. With the rectangle still selected, we hold down Shift and select the spiral as well. In the Path menu, we select Union to combine the two shapes. Depending on your size, there might be some leftover parts from the interior part of the spiral. To delete those, choose Break Apart in the Path menu and delete the leftovers. Lastly, we select the circle and the outer form and select Difference from the Path menu to cut the circle out from the outer form. You can now either print the shape and cut it on a bandsaw, or you could import it in a CAD program to then cut it on your CNC machine. Besides the floating shelves I mentioned in the beginning, excenter levers can be pretty helpful, for example, as panel clamps. Do you have any other ideas where to use them? Let me know in the comments. I will continue to experiment with excenters. If you are interested in these and many other projects, please subscribe to my channel.